So I took zero notes during my time as an engineering student at university. Yeah, I really took zero notes. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I did it and how after I started doing it, I actually performed better. Hi everyone, my name is Adriaan and I'm a mechanical engineer. Research has shown that summarizing, rereading, highlighting are not that good study techniques. In comparison, active recall, spaced repetition, and practice testing are effective and evidence-based practices that really work when you want to study something. So what strategy did I use if I didn't take any notes? Let's get into it. My learning strategy contains three pillars: active recall, spaced repetition, and practice testing. I implemented this strategy by planning out my week first, doing some pre-study before I attend the lecture. I attend the lecture, and then I do some review after the lecture is completed. So every week, I plan out what I'm going to study that week based on the topics that will be covered in my classes for that week. So if I see topic A is on Monday, topic B is on Tuesday, and topic C is on Thursday, I will review those topics the day before. So for example, if topic B is on Tuesday, then I will review the content on the Monday before the lecture. Now, why am I doing this? Well, for one, a good night's sleep will help embed and organize the information in my brain before I attend the class. And two, I've personally found that when I go to a lecture and I've already seen the content, I'm much more confident to ask questions if I don't understand anything, or I'm much more organized in my learning and I feel I can take it in more effectively because it's not the first time I'm seeing it and there's no panicking going on. It's like, oh, what did he just say? I don't know this. Or, oh, I've lost him there. All of that is sort of minimized because I've prepared to an extent before I came to the lecture. Now I know what I'm going to study for the week. I know in what order I'm going to study it, but now I need to go and look at what it is exactly that I'm going to study. The first thing I do is I usually just skim through the content very briefly, just to get that first iteration in of what the content's all about. And this usually won't take me 5 minutes because I'm just paging through the content, be that a lecture, course notes, a handbook, whatever. I just want to get a really general idea of what the content is about. Like, oh, the content's about the equations of motion. So, okay, what am I learning about these equations? I'm learning about linear and rotational scenarios for these equations of motion. So then I know now, all right, this topic is going to cover equations of motion and we're going to only focus on linear and rotational scenarios. So that's done. The next thing I want to do is I want to learn all the terms. If there's a certain term in the lecture or in the content that you're going through that you don't understand, like for example, what's the difference between uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration, I want to look it up to make sure I know the difference before going to class. Now, figuring out all these terms and making sure I understand what they are would usually take me again about 10 to 20 minutes, depending on how much terms there are that you don't understand. Now, if these terms are quite complicated and the definition just doesn't stick in your head, I would make a flashcard for it to make sure that I can review it after this whole session is completed. Okay, so now I've got a general idea of the topic that's being covered in this lecture. I've looked up all the terms I don't understand, and now we need to go and dive a little bit deeper into this content that we need to prepare. Now, I don't just want to reread it in more depth. I usually go and find like a third party source for this content. So that can either be some other notes on the internet, or it can be even a YouTube video. Literally today, you can find YouTube videos on absolutely anything. So you can just try and find a video, for example, covering equations of motion for uniform and non-uniform acceleration. And then I just usually go and watch that. Now again, this is just for you to get a better feeling for the content. You don't take any notes, you don't take any flashcards. It's just another iteration for you to better understand what is being covered in this topic. And then once you've completed that, you can then start asking yourself, all right, how would I go about explaining this to a friend? And if you wanted to quiz him, for instance, what questions would you ask to make sure that you can gauge if you understood the topic or if you understood your explanation of it. Now, usually when I go through this sort of exercise, those questions that I sort of come up with, I put them in flashcards, which I will then use to review this content later on. And that is the last step of this whole pre-study section, is creating flashcards from the content. So this is where the magic happens, creating flashcards. This is where you're going to convert the information that you've gone through during the pre-study phase, and you're going to put it in flashcards, which you are going to use to revise this content up until you write the exam. There are a lot of flashcard tools that can actually automatically space them out, and then you just log on and they give you cards that you've seen a long time ago, and then that active recall and space repetition is automatically done for you, which is really neat. So a few things about creating flashcards. Number one, don't memorize the flashcards. You need to actually understand the content that's being tested on the flashcard itself. When I first started creating flashcards, I fell into this trap where I would just memorize it. And so then I don't really understand it, but I know exactly what the answer is of this flashcard. For example, if I was learning about normalizing a material, I would try and understand, all right, normalizing material is when you heat it up, and then after it's reached a certain temperature, you take it out of the oven and it cools down in the atmosphere. But I didn't understand what normalizing does to the microstructure of the material. I didn't even know why would you normalize a material. I just knew, oh, it's heating up a material, you take it out and you cool it off outside of the oven. That's it. Now, you should know this before you learn about normalizing or about the other heat treatment techniques or why you would use the different types of heat treatment techniques. These information is important that you, when you put it in the flashcards, because obviously you need to know it. But first of all, you need to make sure that you understand the content before you start practicing with the flashcards. The second important factor when you create flashcards is you need to limit the amount of flashcards you use. If you create a flashcard for each and every single bit of information that you're going through, you will get overwhelmed with all the flashcards that you need to go through for revision. And finally, when you make the flashcards, do go have a look first to see if there hasn't been flashcards made already for the topic that you're revising. This will save you a lot of time, as then you can just download those flashcards, maybe add a few more that's missing for your specific needs, and then you can just revise it and save a lot of time compared to having to go and create it from scratch. Now, obviously, these pre-made decks are not always available for every single subject out there, so you might end up having to create your own. And that's it. That's the pre-study section done. Now, that was the day before the lecture. Now, the only thing that's left is for you to attend the lecture. Now, on the day of the lecture or the online session or the whatever session you're going to, I would usually just try to show up, sit there, be engaged, and try and soak up everything that the lecture is telling you, and sort of trying to understand exactly what's going on. And as the lecture is going through the content, I try to ask myself, all right, how would you go about asking this content in a question? How would I formulate that question? And then you keep that in mind, because that question you can obviously put in a flashcard. Also, if he's just finished explaining some sort of concept, you need to go and ask, all right, can I explain this to a friend? Do I understand this? What parts don't I understand? And for sections that you don't understand, you can create a flashcard there and then in the lecture, or maybe just afterwards. The idea of attending the lecture is to ask any questions if you have, or to top up your pre-study material flashcards that you've already made, and just make sure that it is sort of nicely rounded off and complete and ready for revision. And after the lecture, you have got everything set up for your revision, for your spaced repetition activities afterwards. And usually, or most of the cases for me at least, I would never revisit that lecture content again. That PowerPoint, that course notes, it's not necessary to go through it again, because just rereading it, highlighting it, it's not going to be useful. Everything has been converted into useful flashcards, which I can use for revision. The only time when I would ever go back to the content that was discussed by the lecturer, the PowerPoint, if there was any example problems or any content that I forgot to put in a flashcard and I just need to go quickly see what it was and then put in a flashcard. But other than that, it's in the past. So now we've got the flashcards working like a well-oiled machine. How do we kick this up a notch? How do we advance to the next step in our learning? Well, the answer to that question is practice testing and spaced repetition. When I do practice questions, I try and do them often. I try and get questions from the textbook that is maybe linked to the course that you're doing. Maybe there's problems that the lecturer has made available. Anything that you can get, you go and get it, you solve it, because the more you do, the better you get at it, the better your understanding will become of it, and it will make you just that much more prepared for when the exam comes. Also, if you're using a flashcard app, that app will start kicking out flashcards in a spaced manner, and you will be reviewing that content, and it will start to accumulate in your long-term memory so that you're ready for when the exam comes. Now repeat this in all of your subjects that you take in university and you will improve. At least I know I did. It isn't easy, let me tell you that. You will definitely feel the difference from just watching a tutorial, just watching how the lecturer does the problem, compared to actually doing it. You feel your brain working. It's like a muscle, obviously, and you're exercising it, compared to just sitting at the gym and watching other people exercise. You are in the thick of it. You are practicing. You are strengthening your brain muscle. For ensuring I keep to this strategy in the long term, I use methods like the Pomodoro method, which I discuss in this video. If you are a final year student and you need to get started on your final year project, do check out this video that I made especially for you. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.